So, okay, we're going to be hearing continual learning everywhere this year. And honestly, if you're anywhere near the Claude code crowd, cursor, Codex, whatever, you probably already feel it. But here's the real question. Is this just another AI buzzword, or is there actually something for us, something that means we finally get tools that remember us, not just the code? Just real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been living in the iOS trenches for over 8 years. Started out freelancing, working with clients, bouncing between all sorts of projects. But after Dub25, I went all in on solo dev life. Since then, I've crafted over 10 of my own apps, started building everything in public, and honestly, right now, pretty much all my energy goes into making this solo studio into something that lasts, not just another round of quick MVPs or AI slop. The kind of apps that actually scale up. And yeah, I'm sharing every bit of that on Crafters Lab. It isn't just another tutorial site or some AI clone farm. This is my actual home base. It's for solo devs who want to use AI like a real teammate, not like a vending machine. If you're serious about leveling up, building with care, and making apps that actually last, you'll feel right at home. And yeah, if you're still on Patreon, massive thanks. But heads up, everything's have moved over to crafterslab.dev. That's where it's all happening now. So come be part of the crew. Would love to have you building with us. So here's the pain. Every AI agent you use, from Claude Code to Codex, is basically stuck in the same Groundhog Day. You start a session, it's a genius, but the minute your context window fills up or you open a new chat, everything you taught it, gone. Every prompt, every correction, all those weird little rituals you've built up to get good output just disappears. It's like coding with someone who has perfect recall for 5 minutes, then complete amnesia after lunch. Honestly, this is the biggest friction point for solo devs. Like for teams, maybe you document stuff, you pass around .md files, you train up new folks. For solo builders, it's just you and your agent, and every reset is lost hours, lost flow, lost trust. That's why continual learning is such a holy grail for us. It's the dream of an agent that's not just good at coding, but good at coding with you, because it's learning from every nudge, every fix, every late night, wait, don't do it that way correction. And it's not just about the model being smart. It's about not having to write the same rules.md for the 10th time. It's about opening Claude, Cursor, Codex, and having it already know your don't over-engineer. No third-party packages unless I say so. Always SLC, never MVP vibe. No more babysitting, just build. That's the heart of continual learning. Can the model remember my project, my patterns, my pain points, and get better over time? Or am I doomed to keep copy-pasting my brain into a new context window forever? So, what are we talking about when we say continual learning? Here's where it gets nerdy, but I'll keep it grounded. For humans, it's obvious. You learn, you practice, you get better. Learn guitar, pick up violin later. Yeah, you're rusty, but you don't forget guitar, right? For neural networks, and especially big language models, that's not how it works. After training, most models are frozen, like hard stop, no more learning. You can fine-tune, but that usually means overwriting what's already there, sometimes even forgetting old stuff to fit new stuff in. Catastrophic forgetting, real thing, look it up, it's a wild ride. So, when folks say continual learning, sometimes they just mean bigger context windows. The model remembers more of the current chat. Sometimes it's retrieval or external memory, pulling in docs or past sessions, but you know, half the time the model misses the important stuff or gets overwhelmed. But the dream? The dream is a model that doesn't just remember this session or that PRD, but actually gets better at working with you over time. Imagine fixing a bug with Claude today and tomorrow. It not only remembers the fix, but spots a similar issue on its own and suggests a better path, or it just stops making the same mistakes twice because it learned your way. That's the holy grail level, true continual learning, where the model adapts to you session after session. And yeah, we're not fully there yet, but the cracks are starting to show in the old frozen model approach. Between skills that update MCP protocols that pull in fresh project data, and self-updating scripts, we're finally seeing glimpses of agents that feel like they're learning, even if it's more smart retrieval than full-on brain rewiring. So yeah, right now we're mostly in the early innings, longer context, clever memory, manual skill updating. But even these hacks can make it feel like continual learning. And for solo devs, that's already a win. Okay, so here's where it gets practical, because yeah, true continual learning is still on the horizon, but that doesn't mean we're stuck with amnesia mode forever. Here's how I'm handling it right now and where I think most solo devs can start even before the next gen models drop. First, write it down. I know, but your rules.md, mindset.md, or just a living Claude.md in every project. It's the closest thing to persistent memory you'll get. Every time you teach your agent something, don't nest this view. Always use struct unless there's a reason. No magic numbers. Drop it in the file. Next session, next project, new agent. That doc is your bridge. Second, use skills and MCPs as manual memory. Whenever Claude or Codex support self-updating skills, lean into it. If you can run a slash reflect command or use a stop hook that auto-analyzes your last session, do it. Even if it means a little setup, it pays off fast. The best sessions I've had lately are the ones where the agent can see my live skills and update instructions without me copy-pasting all night. And third, treat every session as training, not vending machine time. You're not just getting answers. You're teaching the agent how you build. If it messes up, correct it. If it nails something, drop a note in your .md file or a skill update for next time. Over time, it starts to feel like you're onboarding a real teammate, not just smashing buttons and hoping for the best. Is it perfect? Not even close. But for solo devs, these workflows are the first taste of what continual learning could be. Tools that slowly shape themselves to your style, your quirks, your code base. The more you use them, the better they get. And, you know, if you ever hit that wall of, ugh, why doesn't Claude just know me by now? Remember, it's not just you. We're all hacking around the memory gap together. But every session you invest in documenting your vibe, every little improvement you log in your workflow, that's you building your own agent one step at a time. So, yeah, if you're still hanging out, honestly, you're a legend. No joke. Continual learning isn't just some abstract promise for solo devs. It's this little glimmer of hope that maybe, just maybe, we'll finally get to stop babysitting our tools and start building in real flow. And yeah, until the tech fully catches up, the best move is to treat your workflow as the training ground. Every note, every tweak, every new skills.md or rules.md update, you're laying the groundwork for the tools you wish existed. And yeah, check out crafterslab.dev. It's not just some tutorial dump. It's not another AI clone farm. It's honestly my home base. I built it for solo devs who treat AI like a real teammate, not just a button you smash when you're stuck. And you know, it's packed. You get full walkthroughs, like actual short video tutorials, a ton of Claude code skills in the pipe. And yeah, resources means straight up downloadable zips you can drop right into your project. Members get to actually riff in the comments, ask follow-ups, go back and forth, and yeah, that's just the start. Because the real core is the Notion team spaces. My live playbook, members get a front row seat to my command center, every app I'm building, all the .md files I'm actually using on real projects, the prompt library, the docs I'm writing as I go, and all the automations I'm wiring up behind the scenes. There's a full curated Swift and Swift UI library team space too, not just some pile of old auto-generated files, but real up-to-date stuff. It's packed with the kind of deep dive keynotes and private talks I paid some $100 for, honestly. You won't find any of this in the public training data. This is all the modern real-world code I use myself to fine-tune models and build out my own custom MCPs for Claude Code, for Cursor, all of it. There's a bunch of different ways to use it, and I'm always experimenting, always posting about it in the lab. And then there's Ops Lab. It's where I build and share all my Notion AI agent instructions, Notion templates, the Claude code skills, the workflows, automations, all wired up and ready for you to copy, tweak, totally break, and make your own. The whole point is to keep the indie stack connected so you don't feel like you're building in a silo, even if you're solo at the keyboard. So, yeah, if you want to get in before it gets busy and prices start moving, now's kind of the sweet spot. The crew's still small, super hands-on, and honestly, it feels way more like a behind-the-scenes dev lounge than some giant faceless forum. Would love to see you in there, swap some stories, maybe even learn something from what you're building next. All right, that's it for me. Keep crafting, keep shipping. Peace.